Hey guys, the product database will help you generate product ideas, which is perfect if you don't know what you want to sell yet on Amazon. What we've done is recatalog Amazon's products in our own database with filters that are user-friendly for sellers. Let me show you how to use it. The first thing to do is to set your filters. Select the Amazon marketplace to look in, then the categories you want to search. Let me share with you three jungle tips for those new to selling on Amazon. First off, we recommend staying away from some of the electronics categories as they have a lot more moving parts and chances of things going wrong with them. Remember, it's a good idea to keep your product simple. Next, we also recommend avoiding grocery and gourmet food. Anything that goes in or on your body can be a higher risk. And finally, in the clothing category, we've found buyers tend to be quite brand loyal and less likely to purchase from a no-name brand. Just some things to keep in mind. After the categories, you've got product tier. For beginners, we recommend standard size products. Oversized products are larger and heavier and therefore more expensive to ship. Amazon can also impose restrictions on how many you can send in at a time. The type of seller indicates if the product is being fulfilled by Amazon, fulfilled by merchant, or sold by Amazon themselves. If you don't check the fields, it will search all of them. Next, searching using price has its advantages. We have found that profit margins start to get small if you search below $15, so I'd keep that in mind and maybe not go lower. You can also use our net filter column to help with this. The net value refers to the profit left over once you subtract Amazon's FBA fees from the sales price. Setting the filter to be at least $10 or $15 will therefore achieve the same goal. Don't forget to consider all expenses though. In addition to Amazon's fees, you also need to factor in the wholesale cost of your product and how much it will cost for you to ship it from the supplier to Amazon. For instance, if your product costs $5 per unit and $1 per unit for shipping, and you want at least a $10 profit margin, then you will need to set your minimum net amount to $16 to cover these expenses and still achieve the profit margin you're after. You can select other filters such as bestseller rank or a product's weight. We like number of reviews as it can help you gauge the level of competition on that listing, and we'd suggest looking for a maximum of 100 reviews or even 50. Another jungle tip, look for products with high sales but a low star rating to find products to improve upon. The LQS or listing quality score tells you how good the product listing is. All the products in our database have a score between 1 and 100, with 100 being a great listing. So look for listings with a low listing quality score, meaning you have the opportunity to improve upon the marketing of your product. One filter we always recommend is sales. When looking for a product, you want there to be high demand, but low competition. Since demand is represented by sales, we suggest looking for a minimum of at least 300 sales per month. There is also revenue if you have a particular number in mind that you're shooting for. Otherwise, using sales is completely fine. You have the option of including or excluding keywords if you're really trying to narrow down a particular niche. If you use this tool, we found the best results come from keeping the keywords fairly broad and not put in too many. Remember, you don't need to use all these filters at once, but pick and choose the most important to you and play around with different combinations to discover different product opportunities. As you do this, you have the ability to save a filter set, so you can return to that search at any point in the future. Just hit the Load Filter Set button. You'll see we've also included some of our own presets to get you started. Once you're ready, hit search. The total number of results will be shown to the left, and over here, you can download them to view them in a spreadsheet later on. The listings will be displayed below with all the information from the filters above. You can sort by any of the columns, ascending or descending. Click the title to view the listing on Amazon. You can even click the ASIN to bring up a keyword cloud of all the most used keywords within that listing and title. Over here, you can get a full breakdown of the Amazon fees, and below that, you can click on the net amount to access our FBA Profit Calculator. This is a really powerful tool. With it, you can test any sales price, input the cost of the product to calculate how much profit you would receive if you were to sell that product, and remember, don't forget to factor in that other big expense, shipping to the Amazon warehouse. Being able to quickly see the profit margins for different prices is incredibly handy. On the right-hand side, you've got the ability to add any listing of interest to the product tracker. We update all the sales estimates regularly, but if you want to know it down to the minute, then click Refresh Product Data. And that is the product database. Good luck scouting, and please feel free to reach out if you have any questions.